This is an overview and demonstration of the medium machinery injection molding machine. I'm going to do a little demonstration of how we create an overmolding piece that goes into our sensor line. And so this is the machine itself. Just kind of my setup here. The molds I've actually created from a Sureline CNC. So this CNC ends up drilling and shaping various molds that I end up using in the medium machinery injection molding machine. Now, the pieces of this thing, the top part here, this is a ram jack. Basically, it's I've got it set up as a 20-ton jack pushing on a ram. It's a big steel beam here with a cylinder, and there's essentially a cylindrical injection chamber down and goes all the way down to this level, and the mold actually fits in this area. And although I don't know if you'll be able to see it, there's a nozzle that is where the plastic comes out, and it goes through the sprue and into the mold that's clamped here. So this other jack is also, I have as a 20-ton jack, pushing as the what they call the clamp force, the mold clamping device. So that keeps the two halves of the mold together and then pressed up against the injection. Now the size of these jacks is a little bit over size for what the machine is supposed to handle, but I found that the it really kind of helps in terms of the ease of use of the machine, because you don't have to push it quite so hard. You don't have to do the manual jack as much. The jacks last longer and so on. So that's what we're looking at here. And what we're going to be injecting today is a plastic product called Santoprene, and it's an Exxon Mobil thermoplastic elastomer. And so once it's injected and it's so-called dried, it's actually flexible and very durable at the same time. Now, what I've discovered is that the injection temperatures don't necessarily relate to the data sheets, and I find that I have to keep the temperature controller up a little hotter than what the melt temperature on a data sheet might say. So in this case, I'm injecting the Santoprene at 265, that's centigrade. So let's take a quick look at the mold we're going to use. It's again, this was done by the Sureline CNC. This has actually got two inserts, or several inserts into it. One is a machine screw that's going to become part of the part, and the other is a low voltage line. I'm going to grab a piece of that here now. Sorry for the jiggling. So the low voltage line is going to go in like this. I'm going to set the camera down here and go ahead and put the top on this. So a couple of things on how this mold was made. There are these 5/16 guide pins, and nobody ever said what sizes any of these things should be, and so I just kind of figured it out myself. The other holes that you see in here are actually hold down holes that were created as a part of creating the mold itself. This is what the mold looks like with the wire coming out of it, and now we're going to insert it into the mold. So I'm going to try to film this and get my glove on. Once you're in production, this mold becomes very hot, so there's no way to work with it without some gloves. So I'm going to put it in here. One thing to note is that there's a backstop that's adjustable on the medium machine, and that's back here, so you can adjust these retaining nuts and the back bar here to make sure that your mold fits. And so that's a nice feature. I thought originally I would end up creating some guide molds as, or side guides as well. But I found out I didn't really need that. I did determine where the center of the injection is, and I put a little, I guess fingernail polish is how I did that, is to basically mark it. And then one of the features of the molds that I make is that it's also got a center guide on it. So I can get this in here, line that up, and then we'll start running the clamp jack and tighten this up a little bit. Okay, this is part of the fact that the 20-ton jack is pretty strong, so I don't have to crank on this very hard. I just kind of set it, and then we'll lower the shield here. I've never really had anything pop out of there if there's, you know, mold involved. If you push plastic out and there's no mold there, then sometimes the pressure release from inside the chamber to outside plastic will actually pop. So that's a time where you want to be pretty careful. Now we'll go ahead and close the valve for the ram jack. And just one other thing here to show you is that the air compression, this ram jack is actually driven by a pneumatic motor in the back here. So that's the pneumatic motor driving the jack, and the air for that pneumatic is actually coming from this DeWalt air compressor system. So this is not a particular cheap air compressor. It'll go up to 200 psi, and the holding tank in it I have set at about 65 pounds per square inch. So that actually helps to derate this 20-ton jack, so it's not going to be putting out all 20 tons of force. I'm going to go ahead and shut off this air compressor so that it doesn't come on during the injection, which it normally does. And what you'll see then is, or what you'll hear is, the normal operation of the injection itself. So we've got a device here that gives the that's the pneumatic valve, and we're going to go ahead and go. It changes the sound, okay? And it's a bit of an art to know when to stop this, and so it changes from mold to mold. We'll usually give this about 10 to 15 seconds of hold time in the mold. That gives it a chance to set up, and once that, we'll release the pressure there. Go ahead and flip up the shield down below and release the clamp force by twisting that counterclockwise. Usually in production, I'll go ahead and we'll use these handles to kind of push the clamp down so it'll release the mold, and then we'll retighten the clamp back, get this set up for the next run. So I'm gonna go ahead and pull the mold out of here. Okay. I'm going to set this down and pull the mold open. Okay, I've separated the mold. Did that just with my gloved hands, pulling the mold apart. One of the nice things about the Santoprene is that it's very easy to demold an object. And so this is actually what it looked like after I was done. So of course it's still halfway sitting in the mold. In fact, this is the what they call the sprue side of the mold. This is the B side where the injection went in, and so we're actually looking at what might be called the bottom of the part. Now for us, I can just pull this out. There we go. So that's all a lot smoother when you have two hands to work with, but So this is the piece here, and you can see the sprue. And so all we had to do really for this particular part was to cut off the sprue. You know, if you've got the timing wrong a little bit, particularly because this wire has air gap on it, you may end up with some flash that goes down the wire. But in this case, we had nothing, and all we had to do was cut off the sprue, and we've got the part. So very, very little post-processing to do on this particular part. And again, this is a strain relief that ends up being screwed onto the box. And the short piece here, that's that'll get a little splice for a connector to power the sensor inside the box. So I'm going to load up another mold, and this time I'm going to leave the compressor on so you can kind of hear how the two work together, and we'll do another shot here. One of the things I wanted to show you is the hopper area, something that's not normally seen in a lot of the videos that I've seen of the medium machinery, but you can see the cylinder being pushed down. There is a little hole here that you basically just, you know, shove material in, and you know, the hopper itself doesn't necessarily automatically do that for you, but you got a nice big little tray here to hold the Santoprene or ABS pellets or whatever you're using. Okay, so I've loaded the mold here, and it's ready to go. We don't usually like to keep that in the heated mold too long, because that wire will actually get a little bit soft, and when the shot goes in, it'll bend it. So we're going to go ahead and get the shot going here, and you'll hear the compressor coming in as well. Out of the part and separated, and you can see a little bit of the flash here. And for Santoprene anyway, it gets a lot tougher as it gets cooler, and so one of the things that I do right away is to pull that flash off. And typically, because there's a seam there, it'll pull off pretty easily, and so you can snap it right off.